Hi, boys and girls, and welcome to Science Time at Questacon. My name is Dion.
And I'm BJ.
And today we're talking about space and rockets.
Let's go blast off.
Wake up, sun and moon. It's science time. It's science time. Wake up, skeleton. It's science time. It's science time.
Does anyone know what we might be talking about today? Any ideas?
Rockets.
Space and rockets, exactly. Yeah. So we're talking about space and rockets. Now, can anyone be a rocket? First of all, can everyone be a rocket for me? Can everyone show me your rocket? Ooh. Well, boys and girls, try and be a rocket. We're going to be rockets
rocket
today.
Arms.
Now, rockets go into space. Can anyone tell me, where is space?
It's up in the sky.
It's up in the sky, isn't it? So if you look in the sky, what color is the sky today?
Blue.
It's blue, isn't it? And beyond the blue, past all the blue, there's space. Now, what sort of things do we see in space? What sort of things are in space? Aliens might be in space. We don't really know yet, though. But aliens could be in space.
And rockets.
And rockets can be in space, they can.
And rocks.
And rocks. There are rocks floating around in space, and those can be called asteroids.
And
really? And you were very right. When you said planets,
yes.
There are lots of planets in space
I've
as well.
I've got a photo of some planets that are out in space.
Now, does anyone know what planet do we live on? Oh, we don't. We live on Earth. Well done.
And here is a picture of what the Earth looks like from space.
Looks very nice.
You can see all the clouds floating around.
Now, on Earth, does anyone know what country we live in? Who knows what
Australia.
Country? We live in Australia. So we live in Australia on Earth.
Right there.
That's us right there.
That's our home.
So what other things can you find in space? Any ideas? What do you think?
Is this not orange?
Well,
orange.
No.
On this
there's the big
round
rocks and the alien
there are big round rocks. Those are the asteroids that we were talking about before. The sun.
The sun.
Well done. You can see the sun.
Here's a photo of the sun.
Now, can you see the sun in the daytime or the nighttime?
Daytime.
Daytime. You see the sun in the daytime. And sometimes you can see the moon in the daytime as well. Is the moon in space?
Yep.
It is, isn't it? The moon is in space. You can see, yes, sometimes you can see the moon at the daytime, also at the nighttime as well. What do you think?
My grandpa used to have a rocket ship.
Did he used to have a rocket ship, your grandpa? Very lucky grandpa then, very lucky grandpa.
I've got a photo here of a rocket ship.
And what's this coming out to the bottom of the rocket ship, do you think?
Fire.
It's fire. And smoke as well.
I've got a book about rockets.
Do you? Do you have a book about rockets? They're lots of fun. So this rocket uses the lots and lots of fire down the bottom to shoot up into the air, into space.
And my sister's got a book about fire because she needs to learn a lot about airplanes.
There are lots of books about space stuff out there, definitely.
I've got a book about airplanes. Well, and it's got rocket ships.
And rocket ships in it as well. Now, what about what sort of things do you see twinkling in the night sky?
Stars.
There are lots of stars in space as well. Now, do you know that stars are actually a lot like our sun? They're actually big sort of balls of flaming gas, of burning gas. And that's why they shine so brightly, because they're exactly, almost exactly like our sun. It's pretty
but
cool.
But they don't look like the sun because they're a long, 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 long way away.
They are. They're very, very far away, those stars.
What is somebody that flies up in space called?
Do you know? An eagle. Oh, an eagle does fly, but what sort
up
of what is
space,
a person that goes into
that
space?
Lives in space.
An astronaut.
Well done. Now, an astronaut is a person that goes into space that's from the USA. But someone from Russia can be called a cosmonaut, and someone from China can be called a taikonaut. So there are lots of different types of nauts, I suppose. But this is an astronaut, this one here.
Do you know, there are some people that actually live in space. They live in a place called the International Space Station. Who here
And the International Space Station is a bit like a big house floating in space.
Who would like to live in space?
I think it'd be lots of fun.
Yeah.
Yeah. I think it'd be really cool.
And I would even to bounce on the moon.
You could bounce on the moon.
Yes.
But that's where aliens.
You might even meet aliens if you're very, very lucky. That's where rockets go up to, don't they? They go up to the space station to meet all other astronauts and that sort of thing. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Now, what we might do is we're actually going to watch a video of a rocket taking off. Now, astronauts, how do astronauts get to space? Do they drive a car?
No.
Do they swim to space? Do they swim to space?
No, they fly in a rocket.
They do. They fly in a rocket ship, don't they? So we're going to have a look. It is. They get out of their rocket ship sometimes. So what we're going to do is we're going to look at a rocket ship blasting off. We've got a video.
I'll go press play.
So BJ's going to press play. And what we're going to do, we're all going to turn on our bottoms. Can you turn your bottom and have a look over there for me? So BJ's going to press play. And here we've got our big rocket. And this rocket is so big, it's bigger than Questacon. So ready? Counting down. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Blast off! Now our rocket is blasting off into the sky, and there's our astronaut who's flying the rocket, and you can see our rocket is going very, very fast indeed.
And it's a red astronaut.
It is. It's a red astronaut, that one. Now our this rocket ship has got lots of fire coming out the bottom, and when it runs out of fuel, it drops off parts of the of the rocket ship. So it's burnt all the fuel in that part of the rocket ship, so it drops that off. Then it starts using fuel in the next part. Drops off more bits when it runs out of more fuel. And that small bit at the front is the bit where all the astronauts are. That's where they are, nice and safe. So they drop off the last part, and the astronauts are safe in space, ready to go to the moon, these astronauts. Now, what they're going to do, so they can use lots of things on the spaceship and keep them sort of with electricity, they're going to fold out these solar panels that take electricity from the sun. And this helps them sort of fly about the place and helps to keep them sort of safe in their spaceship. It looks a bit like a satellite, doesn't it? Now we're going to look at another rocket ship. We're going to do our countdown again. Ready? 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Blast off!
I thought that the last rocket
was flying. Yeah, it's flying a little bit like the last one. You can see the smoke and the fire coming out of the bottom. This is a little bit different, but you can see it's going very, very far away from Earth. And it's going to zoom across, zoom, really, really fast. Now, this rocket will also start sort of taking bits off when it runs out of fuel.
Like that.
Yep, so it drops those bits
and
off.
And then it connects it back onto a new rocket.
It does. So what this thing is going to do, it's actually going to connect to the rocket with all the people inside it, with all the astronauts inside. So more bits drop off as well, and it goes all the way towards the moon, which is very, very exciting indeed. Yes, yeah, so they're safe inside. All the astronauts are safe inside. They're not going to fall out at all. The reason the rocket breaks up is because it doesn't need those bits anymore. And they're really, really heavy, which makes it go a bit slower. So it wants to go faster, so it drops off all those bits there. Now, has anyone ever seen a rocket like this before?
Yes.
What rocket is this? Does anyone know?
A balloon.
A balloon rocket. Now, what do we need to put inside our balloon rocket for it to fly? We need air for our balloon rocket. So what we're going to do is we're going to put some air inside this balloon rocket. There we are. So pumping the air inside. Ooh, that one was a pretty loud rocket, wasn't it?
That does hurt my ears.
That was, hopefully we didn't have any astronauts on that rocket. Fingers crossed.
That was a loud noise, wasn't it?
Now, this one will be a lot better. I promise this one won't explode. Okay, this one will make a bit of a sound when it takes off, but I'll warn you because we'll do our countdown. So here we are, we're going to pump up our rocket. Lots of air inside. There we are. Now, before we launch our rocket, what do we have to do?
Countdown.
We need to count down. So this rocket's going to make a bit of a sound when it takes off. We're going to count down. Ready? It's going to make right to the sky. So ready? 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Blast off! Wow!
Wow!
Very exciting. Look at that.
That's funny.
It sounds a bit funny, doesn't it? Thank you very much. There we are. So this rocket needed air to take off. What did the other rocket need that we looked at before? Well, it needed fire, didn't it? It needed fire and smoke and fuel. That's how it took off.
Fire.
So we've got lots of things to look at and lots of space to play in today in Science Time. So ready, set, go. Find your grown-up and explore the room.
Go. See what you can
find.
With all our rockets inside, Dion and I are going to take you outside to launch a really high rocket. Come and see.
Hi boys and girls. Dion and I are outside Questacon to launch our big water rocket. Now we had to come outside because this is too big to do indoors.
Much too big.
And we've got water in our rocket and we're going to pump some air in there as well. Now as I pump the air in the rocket, you can see those air bubbles in the water. Lots of air is going into this rocket and the air pressure is getting higher and higher. Oh, those air molecules are getting really squashed together inside the rocket. Oh, it's a bit hard to pump now. I think it's full as it's going to be. Now, what we're going to do, we're going to launch our rocket. And when we do, all the air and the water is going to push out the bottom. All the water and air will go down and that will push the rocket up into the sky. But we've got to do our countdown.
We do.
Are we ready?
Five, four, three, two, one, zero,
blast off! Wow!
So we play with lots of different things in Science Time today, but we've got one more thing to look at. Today, we're going to make our own rocket ship today, which is really exciting. And instead of using fire, like we saw in the video, we're going to use something else. We're going to use some water and a fizzy tablet in this one.
And this is called a chemical rocket because they're going to combine, they're going to react and make a gas.
So what we have here is a film canister or a little container with a lid. And we're going to put a fizzy tablet inside. Then we're going to put the lid back on top and trap all the fizziness. All the air is going to get really, really squished inside. And hopefully our rocket ship will take off. We'll see.
I don't know.
We might put our...
Yes. So I'll put it in and once it starts fizzing, the gas is going to build up and build up and build up. And what will happen when this little film canister can't hold all that gas?
Blast off.
So for this one, let's all move back. Move back.
Can you move back a little bit?
Way back. And we'll move back too.
We will move back.
Way back. Wiggle. Now make sure if you do this at home, you have mummy and daddy or grown up close by.
Very important to have mum or dad near.
And once you put the fizzy tablet in, you can't go looking at your rocket because then it might blast off and hit you in the head. So once we put it there, we're going to move away and we don't know when it's going to launch off.
So it's a bit of a tricky rocket. We're not sure when it's going to take off. We can't do a countdown for this one.
No.
But when it does, it'll be pretty exciting.
Okay, so are you watching? We'll put the fizzy tablet in, lid on tight, give it a shake and move back, move back.
Oh, shuffling back.
And
Inside the film canister, all the fizzy tablets making lots and lots of gas. It's getting really, really squished inside until eventually all the gas will push on itself and it'll shoot up because the pressure is so high. Now, boy! Very exciting indeed. It's gunky, isn't it? Lots of fun. I think that one hit the roof. I think that would have gone to space, actually, that one there. So coming and sitting, everyone, come a little bit closer.
Back in, come back.
It is pretty good fun, isn't it?
That's a fun one.
A bit scary, but very, very safe though. So if you want to give that one a go at home, what we used was an aspirin tablet, a film canister and some water. But do be careful, make sure mum and dad are there to help you with that experiment.
And what don't you do?
Look at the rocket.
Don't look over the rocket. Well done. Make sure you got a grown up.
So first of all, things that we have got to give away today, we have a parent information sheet. And it gives you some ideas of where to go and what to do in order to learn more about space, which is really, really good fun. So make sure to check that one out. And we've also got a colouring in sheet today as well. Now, can anyone tell me what's this big thing here? It's the moon. Well done. And what are these sparkly things around the moon?
Stars.
And what's this big thing blasting off at the bottom? A rocket ship. So you can have one of these, boys and girls. You can download them from the internet and take them home and colour them in. So sitting down on your bottoms, what we're going to do first of all is we're going to say goodbye to the boys and girls. So can everyone say goodbye to the boys and girls? Waving. See you next science time.
See you next science time.
So who would like a colouring in sheet? Would you like one?
Come and get a colouring in sheet.
Questacon Science Time is held at Questacon in Canberra, Tuesday to Friday during school terms. Bookings are essential. For further information, go to our website at questacon.edu.au. See you next Science Time.